Islam. Islam means thyself, Lord, and Master. I sincerely the love of lies, mathematics. It's your soul coming at you live. You heard me, you dig, well, and record, you know what I'm saying? Fifth corner, pimp, mean putting ignorant minds proper, you dig, not putting hoes and prostitutes on the corner like some of them niggas that wind up a goner doing that type of shit, you dig? If you're pimping, pimp our people out the poverty, pimp our people out the hopelessness, pimp our people out of the fucking fucked up condition we in. If you're pimping, don't just pimp for yourself to make your pockets fat. Pimp to change the reality of our people as a whole. When I say our people, I say the Asiatic, Moorish people that have been misnomer African Americans, formerly known as Negro, Black, or Color. You heard me? So on this YouTube right here, I'm going to talk about the voting thing, you dig? The Voting Right Act and what it means to vote. You know what I'm saying? From a Moorish, Asiatic, so-called Black man perspective, all right? The three things I held up earlier was showing you articles that was published in the news. This, our first article was by CNN. This was published. It's talking about the Voting Right Act ruling is a lazy attempt by Trump nominee judges to overturn a Supreme Court precedent. All right. With the Supreme Court is the highest court in the land, and with the Supreme Court saying different cases, and cases of anybody know legalese or jurisprudence, know that when the Supreme Court say set the precedent for all other cases that goes through county courts, state courts, and federal courts, and on appeals to the Supreme Court. All right. And it's talking about the right to vote, how it pertains to so-called Black people in America. All right. I'm gonna read this article to you that was published on November 20, 2023. All right. It says a U.S. appealing court decision Monday, undercutting the Voting Rights Act of 1965, rejects decades of precedent and appears likely to provoke a confrontation at the United States Supreme Court, where the milestone law has been increasingly under attack. At stake are the voting rights of Blacks, Hispanic, and other racial minorities that have been vindicated under Section of the VRA prohibiting discrimination based upon race. Section 2 has helped ensure the states draw legislation and congressional districts fairly, that minority voters have an opportunity to elect candidates of their choice. All right. The Supreme Court, as recently as June, has reaffirmed Section 2, but the U.S. appealing judge David Strass and the author of the majority opinion in Mother's case from Arkansas observed that Justice Clarence Thomas and Neil Gorsuch have called a key provision of the law into question. His ruling money could ultimately gut the law's protections. All right. It says the decision is the latest of an example of former President Donald Trump's influence over the federal judiciary. Stratus, one of Trump's first appealing court attorneys, defied Supreme Court presidents to boast a conservative interpretation of the law backed by Thomas and Gorsuch, who was Trump's first Supreme Court attorney. In Monday's groundbreaking decision, the 2-1 panel of the 8th Circuit United States Circuit Court of Appeals ruled that the private plaintiffs such as the NAACP, Legal Defense Fund, and American Civil Liberties Union have no right to bring litigation on behalf of voters under Section 2. Stratus was joined in the majority by Circuit Judge Raymond Gauthier and attorney of former President George W. Bush. Citing Thomas and Gorsuch, Stratus said it has been an open question as to how far the law goes. Yet that notion has never drawn a Supreme Court majority. For much of the last half century, Thomas law clerk acknowledged courts have assumed that Section 2 is privately enforceable. But he added, a deeper look has revealed that this assumption rests on friendly footing. The decision swept back a history of legislation and longstanding court interpretations, saying Congress had failed to implicitly detail that private parties could challenge VRA violations. Only the U.S. Attorney General has the right to implicit right, the ruling said. The dissecting judge countered that the foundational principle of American law is that where there is a legal right, there is also a legal remedy. Judge Levinsky Smith, an attorney of former President George W. Bush, added that Congress never intended enforcement of the law, so fundamental to self-government, to be left only to the federal government. Conservatives assault on the Voting Rights Act. The justices on the contemporary court have been deeply divided over the reach of the act passed at the height of the Civil Rights Movement and only after March of 1965, Bloody Sunday. Attacks on marches of the Edmund Patrick Bridge in Alabama. The high court, dominated by conservative justices over the past decade, curtailed federal protections, giving states more latitude for redistricting other electoral practices. All right. Then he went on to say, but the last June, a 5-4 majority reinforced the act protection against discriminatory voting lines by invalidating the Alabama map found to have diluted black voting power. The Alabama legislature had packed much of the state's African-American population into one distinct and divided the rest among other districts. Chief Justice John Roberts, who wrote for the Slim Cross Identity Majority, said Alabama's authority flew in the face of precedent. In the heart of these cases, he wrote, it's not about the law as it exists. It's about Alabama's attempt to remake our Section 2 jurisprudence anew. Thomas, one of the dissectors in that case of Allen versus Manley, specifically noted at the time, the court does not address whether Section 2 contains a private right of action. Only Gorsuch joined that proportionate Thomas dissecting opinion, which echoed a point Gorsuch made 2 years earlier that Thomas signed on to it. Ruling against the Arkansas State Conference, NAACP, which had contended the state diminished black voting power in the redistricting, Stratus said neither the text nor the structure of the VRA gives private plans a clear right to sue under Section 2. If the 1965 Congress clearly intended to create a private right of action, then why not say so in the statute, he wrote. All right. Referring to other voting right advocates that joined the state, the NAACP added the advocate group argued that courts had been adjudicating Section 2 claims brought by private plans for years, so they must be available, but assuming they exist and even discussing them is different from actually deciding that the private right of action exists. All right. It says that contradicts the longstanding Supreme Court and lower federal court's interpretation of the law. Chief Judge Smith wrote in dissection, quote, rights so fundamental to self-government citizenship should not depend solely on the discretion or availability of the government agent for protection, end quote. Smith said, citing research showing that over the past 40 years, there have been at least 182 successful Section 2 sections. Only 15 were bought solely by Attorney General. Smith considered that the Eighth Circuit majority should have left resolution of whether Section 2 can be invoked by private plans to justice rather than trying to predict the Supreme Court future decisions. All right. And that's the 1965 Voting Rights Act that's brought into question Section 2 of it, which is stating that the rights of blacks, Hispanic, and other minorities have the right to vote under the Voting Rights Act, right? Now, for people that's not familiar with the Voting Rights Act, this is another article I flashed up, and I'm not going to read all this on it, because I'm going to put this information in the description of the video where you can check it out. Let me give you a brief on what the Voting Rights Act was of 1965 that gave so-called blacks, Hispanics, and other so-called minority people the right to vote in the United States, all right? It said on August 5th, 1965, the United States passed the Voting Rights Act of 1965. The long-delayed issue of voting rights had come to the forefront because of a voter registration drive launched by civil rights activists in Salem, Alabama. Among Salem, 15,000 black citizens of voting age, only 335 registered to vote. On March 7, 1965, 600 civil rights protesters attempted to march from Salem to the state capital, Montgomery. On what became known as Bloody Sunday, they were stopped by police using tear gas, nightsticks, and whips. Media coverage of the event shocked and inspired citizens from across the country to travel to Alabama in support of Senator 25,000 people led by Dr. Martin Luther King. Complete with the march to Montgomery on March 25th, protected by U.S. troops, the National Guard, and the FBI. That routine had been designated a U.S. National Historical Trail. All right? So, that's a brief of what the Voting Rights Act, how it came about. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to post this article on here. Y'all can read all this for yourself because I'm not going to sit there and read this. But that was something that was brought up in the Civil Rights Act. And the Voting Rights Act was supposed to be renewed every 25 years, right? So if you consider black, Negro, color, Hispanic, or whatever, you're not considered a full-fledged citizen in the country with voting rights, all right? Now, my third article that I'm going to talk about in this YouTube is vote. What it means to vote, and from a spiritual point of view, what a vote is, all right? That's this third article, something I wrote. You see, the word vote is a noun. It's from the mid-15th century. It says, quote, formally express a one wish or church with regard to propose a candidate, etc., end quote. From the Latin votum, V-O-T-U-M, it's, quote, a vow, a wish, a promise to God, seldom pledged, dedicated, end quote. Noun use of nita votis, past objected vorera, to promise, to dedicate. See vow, the meaning totality of voters of a certain class or type. All right, so the word vote basically means when you pledge your allegiance, you pledge or take a vow. You know what I'm saying? It's a promise to God, all right? But they use this vote thing as a promise to them, which, you know what I'm saying, that's something you spiritual, religious people should look at when y'all think about vote, all right? They say vote, a vote is a vow, all right? Let's see what the word vow means. A vow, it means, quote, solemn promise, end quote. 13th century, from Anglo-French or Old French, vote, V-O-E, modern French, vera, from the Latin votum, a promise to a god. Seldom pledged, dictate, dedicated, that which is promised, a wish, desire, a longing, a prayer. Now use of netter of votus, past particle, forever. To promise, solemnly pledge, to dedicate, vow. From the root pi, wait, to speak, solemn, to vow, preach. The Sanskrit, one who offers a sacrifice. Greek, a vow, a wish, I pray. The meaning, solemn engagement, to devote oneself to religious order of life. And from the early Venetian century, to bind oneself to chastise. So the word vote comes from the word vow, and the word vow means to pledge to a god, to dictate yourself to a god or to a religious order thing, or prayer, is also a sacrifice. So these are the things that you're doing when you are voting. You see what I'm saying? So, okay, so the word vote also comes from the word votum, which is V-O-T-U-M. Votum is in ancient Roman religion. A votum, probably vota, is a vow or a promise made to a deity. All right. The word comes from the past particle of the Latin verb vero, viri, vow, promise. As a result of this verbal action, a votum is also that which fulfills a vow. That is the thing promised, such as offerings, a statue, even a temple building. The votum is thus an aspect of the contractual nature of Roman religion, a bargaining expressed by deatus dios. I give that ye might give. All right? Once again, the word vote, comes from ancient Roman religion, means to vow a promise to a god. All right? So what god are you praying to when you vote? You know what I'm saying? You see, the main god or goddess in the Roman culture was Jupiter. Jupiter in astrology is the planet that rules over Sagittarius, and it also rules over the day of the week, which is a Thursday, which is when they mostly have the elections on Thursday. If I'm not mistaken, this year they're gonna have the election on Thursday, so they're voting to the god Jupiter, right? Jupiter, Juno, and Minerva. Jupiter was the sky god who the Roman believed oversaw all aspects of life. He is thought to have originated from the Greek god Zeus. And that's how you get the word Jesus, from the word Zeus. The big three. The three most important gods were Jupiter, protector of the state, Juno, protector of women, and Minerva, goddess of craft and wisdom. Other major gods include Mars, the god of war, Mercury, the god of trade and messenger of gods, and Bacchus, the god of grapes and wine produce. Jupiter was the god of thunder, lightning, and storms, and also the god of light and sky. He was married to Juno, and was the father of many other gods, including Mars, Vulcan, Hercules. When you see pictures of Jupiter, he's usually shown with a long beard. Juno was the ancient Roman queen of the gods and the Roman gods of marriage. She was the daughter of Saturn and the wife of Jupiter. She was also known as protector and special counsel of the state, which was her first role as a goddess. Minerva was the goddess of wisdom, war, art, school, justice, and commerce. She was the escutcheon counterpart, the Greek Athenian, like Athena. Minerva burst from the head of her father, Jupiter, Greek Zeus, who had devoured her mother, Memphis, in an unsuccessful attempt to prevent her birth. All right? So now when you vote, first of all, if you consider a black, African-American, Negro, colored, Hispanic, or minorities, the Voting Rights Act is expired, and it has to be renewed by Congress, which it gives you a privilege to vote, not as a real citizen to vote. As individuals, as private, that's what the Supreme Court is saying, because voting wasn't set up like that. Also, when you vote from a spiritual aspect, you are violating or giving your pledge of allegiance to a deity. And as one of the great prophets that we know of, he said, we strayed after pure European gods who we knew nothing about, and that's why we're in the situation you in. So I'm just assaulting, you did, the fifth kind of pimp, giving you game on where the voting is and what you're voting about, you know what I'm saying? So, peace, Islam.